Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Sam from Historic Travels and welcome to another video. And as always, before we get started today, I'd just like to take a quick moment to welcome all my new subs and to thank everybody who's been leaving me comments and messages down below. Thank you guys so much, I really appreciate it. And if you would like to take a couple extra steps to help support the channel a little bit more, there's a merch store and a Patreon for this channel in the links below. Thank you guys so much for all your support. Oh, and hey, in case you didn't know it, we did get some new stuff on the merch store lately. We've got some iPhone cases, we've got Android phone cases, we've got bags, you know, just a bunch of other little miscellaneous stuff, as well as we did officially add children clothes to my Historic Travels YouTube merchandise lineup. So if you would like to check out all that new merch, go check out the merch store. I think you guys will like everything that's new there. All right, guys. So hey, on to today's topic. Today's video topic is something that has been requested by all of my fans on YouTube for a very long time, and we are finally going to tackle it. So what is today's topic? Well, in today's video, we're going to be talking about what happened to all the animals that were on board the Titanic. We're going to talk about the animals that were confirmed to be on board. We're going to talk about what happened to them and if any of them would survive the sinking of the Titanic. All right, everybody. Well, hey, without any further ado, let's begin today's video.
Most of the animals that were on board the Titanic were basically the pets of some of the passengers who were on board the ship and were traveling with these passengers to America. But we'll talk more about the pets of Titanic in a minute. Before I talk about them, I want to talk about the animals that were on board the Titanic that were not pets to some of the Titanic's passengers. And yes, believe it or not, there were a few animals on board the Titanic that did not belong to the ship's passengers. Probably the most common of these types of animals were, you guessed it, rats. Yes, Titanic, just like all other ships during this time period, had a major problem in dealing with rats that had somehow gotten on board the ship. In fact, the rat problem on Titanic was so bad that on the evening of April the 14th, 1912, at roughly dinner time, one rat ran right through the third-class dining room while dinner was underway, and it caused quite the commotion. Some people screamed and ran from the room, while others in the room tried unsuccessfully to capture the rat. Now, the Titanic also had its own animal crew member on board who was on board the ship specifically to deal with the rat population on the ship. And this animal was Jenny the cat. Now, Jenny has a very interesting story in regards to the Titanic, although we're not going to talk about it in this video. I already made an entire video covering Jenny the cat. If you would like to watch that video, I will include a link to that video in the description below.
Now that we've discussed the animals that were on board the Titanic that really didn't belong to anybody, let's now switch over and talk about the animals that were on board the ship that actually were supposed to be there and actually belonged to people. Now, as far as I know, there were no animals on board the Titanic that belonged to any members of the Titanic's crew. It is true that Captain Smith's dog, a dog named Ben, who was a large Russian wolfhound, visited Captain Smith briefly and did spend one night on board the Titanic. But this dog got off the ship before the Titanic left Southampton, and Ben ended up staying with Captain Smith's daughter after the Titanic left on its maiden voyage. But apart from that, I couldn't find any records of any other crew members having any of their pets on board the ship.
As for the rest of the animals on board the Titanic, these animals were basically the property of the ship's passengers. Now, most of these animals were the pets of the Titanic's passengers, dogs and cats and so on, although there was one canary on board the Titanic briefly. That's pretty cool. However, not all of the animals on board the Titanic were the pets of the passengers. One of the Titanic's passengers was transporting 30 young roosters to America.
Now, any animal that was brought on board the Titanic by one of the ship's passengers each had their own individual ticket price that had to be paid before this animal would be allowed on board the ship. And it was also required that these animals be kept in the ship's kennel, which was located on F deck at the aft end section of the Titanic. And the ticket price for these animals would also vary depending on what type of animal you were bringing on board. And they also took into consideration where this animal was traveling to on board the Titanic. You know that canary that I mentioned earlier that traveled on board the Titanic? Well, this canary was only on board the Titanic as the ship traveled from Southampton to Cherbourg, France. And this canary's ticket price was a grand total of 25 cents.
Now, the dogs that were in the Titanic's kennel were not locked up in that room throughout the entire voyage. In fact, they were exercised daily. It was the responsibility of one of the Titanic's crew members to make sure that these dogs got plenty of exercise. So, once a day, this crew member would take the dogs up to the Titanic's poop deck, where he would walk them, you know, just let them enjoy the fresh air a little bit. That way they didn't get restless. And it was also the responsibility of this crew member to, let's say, clean up any messes that these dogs should leave behind on the Titanic's deck.
Now, even though it does say in the Titanic's rulebook that all dogs brought on board the ship had to be kept in the Titanic's kennel, it does seem like that not every single passenger on board the Titanic obeyed this rule. There are several accounts out there that state that some of the women on board the Titanic kept their small dogs in their stateroom. And it does seem like that some of the crew just said, okay, they were okay with it. Because the funny thing about all this is that the women who had their dogs in their staterooms didn't even make any attempt to hide the fact that they were there. There are several accounts of these women walking around with their small dogs up on the Titanic's boat deck. One of the Titanic's passengers, a man by the name of Francis Millett, actually wrote a letter complaining about this to a friend of his. And believe it or not, this letter only survived the disaster because it was mailed from the Titanic when the ship made its last stop in Queenstown, Ireland before heading across the Atlantic. And in that letter, he complains about how these women are just walking around with these small dogs on the Titanic's boat deck.
Now, I did some research to try to figure out exactly how many dogs and cats were on board the Titanic. And as far as the cats are concerned, with the exception of Jenny, there were no other records of cats on the Titanic that have survived up to this point. And as far as the dogs were concerned, I did find one account that stated that there were 12 dogs on board the Titanic, although I could only find information about 9 of these dogs.
Now, I'm not going to be going into detail about every single dog that we have records of that were on board the Titanic. That would just take too long to go into their entire story. But if you would like to learn more about the dogs that we still have records of that were on the Titanic, I will include a link to the article that I used to research this video in the description below. And I would encourage you to check out the list because there were definitely some pretty interesting dogs on the Titanic. I'll give you a quick little rundown of some of the highlights. There was a dog by the name of Kitty, who belonged to John Jacob Astor, who was on board the Titanic. When I first saw the name Kitty, I thought that John Jacob Astor brought his cat on board the Titanic, but no, they had a dog on the Titanic whose name was Kitty, so that's kind of cool. There was also a French bulldog named Gaiman, who was owned by a man named Robert Williams Daniel. He paid £150 for this dog in 1912, and if you convert that over to today's currency, that same amount of money would be worth £13,393. That is absolutely insane. I can't imagine paying that much money for one dog.
So what was the ultimate fate of all the animals that were on board the Titanic? Well, unfortunately, very few of them would survive the sinking of the Titanic. We only have records that say that 3 dogs were able to survive the entire disaster. However, it does seem like that at some point during the sinking, somebody did go down to the ship's kennel and free the dogs, because there are several accounts out there of people seeing the dogs on the Titanic running around on the boat deck. Now, I heard one story, and I'm not sure how true it is, but I heard that John Jacob Astor went down to the ship's kennel to free the dogs personally. And there is a story that says that when he entered the ship's kennel, he saw water coming into that room when he freed the dogs and got them out. Now, the only thing about this story is, I'm not sure how true it is, because given the position of the kennel on the Titanic, I don't really see how there could be water in there at the time that somebody went in there to free the dogs. I do believe somebody freed them because there were dogs running around on the boat deck, although whether or not it was John Jacob Astor, and whether or not this room was flooding at the time that somebody let the dogs out, that is something that I can't say for certain.
Now, the 3 dogs that did survive the sinking of the Titanic, these dogs were all of the smaller types of breeds, you know, dogs that were small enough to fit on the laps of their owners. These were the only dogs that were allowed into a ship's lifeboat, and honestly, I can't understand that. There's no officer on the Titanic that's going to let a large breed dog into a lifeboat. I mean, that could potentially create a very dangerous situation for that boat, and it would also take a lot of space away from people who were trying to escape the Titanic. But still, just because a dog was a small breed didn't guarantee their safety or guarantee their place in one of the ship's lifeboats. The 3 dogs that survived the Titanic sinking, from what I could find, it seems like 2 of these 3 dogs got into a lifeboat without any problem. But one of these dogs, it seems like the ship's officer who was loading that lifeboat wasn't too keen on letting this dog in, and he actually told this passenger that she could not bring her dog with her. And this passenger absolutely refused to get into the lifeboat without her dog. So the ship's officer reluctantly agreed, and both the dog and her owner got away in this lifeboat. But still, I don't understand that. I don't understand why, if you have a dog that's small enough to fit in your lap, why a ship's officer would protest this dog escaping in one of the Titanic's lifeboats.
Now, when I was researching the story of the three small dogs that did survive the sinking of the Titanic, I did come across another story of another small dog that unfortunately did not survive the sinking. Now, before I tell you this story, I'm going to warn you, it's pretty heartbreaking. The story involves a woman named Helen Bishop who was traveling on board the Titanic, and her small dog Fru Fru was actually accompanying her, and this dog was also staying in Helen's stateroom. She was one of the passengers that ignored the rules about the dogs having to stay in the ship's kennel. Anyway, on the night that the Titanic struck the iceberg and began to sink, Helen was in her stateroom with her dog. And then when one of the ship's crew members approached Helen and came to her cabin and told her that she needed to get up on the boat deck, this crewman also told Helen that she could not bring her dog with her. Now, Helen was very hesitant about leaving her dog behind, but after a while, she reluctantly agreed to leave her dog. She said this was one of the hardest decisions of her life to leave her dog behind. And she also said that as she was leaving her cabin, her dog ran up and grabbed onto her dress and tried to keep her from leaving the room. She later said that the dog really, really wanted to accompany her up to the boat deck. Now, I don't know about all of you, but if I had a small dog that I knew could easily fit into one of the ship's lifeboats, I would have ignored that crew member and taken that dog with me. There is no way I would have left my small dog behind on the Titanic.
So yeah, given the dire circumstances that everybody on board the Titanic was facing on the night of the sinking, odds were extremely slim that any of these passengers would be able to rescue their pets from the doomed Titanic. To be honest, it still is somewhat of a minor miracle that three small dogs were able to be rescued from the Titanic before the ship went down. But I do have one last thing I would like to say on the matter. It does make me happy that somebody on the Titanic actually cared enough about the animals on board the ship to go down to the Titanic's kennel and free these animals and help them try to at least have a shot at escaping the Titanic. I mean, just think about it. Whoever this person was that went down to the ship's kennel, he had to know that the odds of these dogs and cats or whatever was down there, he had to know that the chances of these animals surviving the sinking was extremely slim, but he didn't care. He took the time to go down there, free these animals, help them get up to the boat deck so that they would at least have a shot at surviving the sinking. I mean, think about how deep the kennel was inside the Titanic. It was on F deck, and remember, the bottom of the Titanic is G deck. So it was a lot of effort for this person to go down and get those dogs, cats, or whatever, and help them get up to the boat deck. So the fact that he did this, to be honest, it makes me really happy that whoever this person was actually cared enough about these animals to at least give them a shot at surviving the disaster. Anyway, guys, that's it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and found it interesting. And yeah, now you know the story of the animals that were on board the Titanic. Be sure you leave this video a like, be sure to subscribe. Oh, and hey, in case you guys missed it, I did officially set up a P.O. box for the Historic Travels YouTube channel. If you would like to send me something, I will post the address for that P.O. box in the description below. All right, everybody. Well, hey, thank you all so much for watching. And hey, you all keep doing what you're doing. You guys are awesome. All right, everybody. Well, hey, I'll see you in the next one. Have a good day, everybody. And thank you so much for watching.
Hey, if you'd like the Historic Travels YouTube channel, make sure you check out the Tales of the Protectors book series. Almost Heaven is part one and The Elephant Path is part two. This is a young adult adventure series, and if you'd like the Chronicles of Narnia books, you will love these books. You can check out these books in the link in the description below. Special thanks to our Captain Level Patreon supporters, Greg Gallick and Callum Whaley. Thank you guys so much for all the support.